All right, guys, so we have done a few explainer videos in the past about sequencers. The way they have been traditionally explained before is a little problematic because, you know, we all know that a sequencer does not have a coil. It has a resistive heater right in here, and then it's got thermodiscs that will warp up and down and close these sets of contacts respectively. Now, if it's a stage sequencer, the way it's been traditionally explained before in previous videos is that as the heat rises, the set of contacts that's closest to the heat source will close first. And intuitively, that makes sense, but that's not exactly how all sequencers work. I've seen some where the rated heating and cooling rates for the thermodiscs do match, and the bottom set of contacts will close before the top one. However, a good way to notice whether which side is the first stage is the one with the most contacts, because that's where you're gonna interlock your fan. We look here, we've got points 1, 3, 4, and 5. On here, we're gonna look and say, all right, so points 1 and 3, the bottom set of contacts here, has a heating rate of between 30 and 90 seconds and a cool off rate of 1 and 30 seconds. So this is how long does it take to heat up the thermodisc? How long does it take to cool down and open back up that set of contacts? Between points 4 and 5, the top set of contacts here, it's going to heat up within 1 and 30 seconds and cool off between 45 and 110 seconds. This is gonna be the first one on, the last one off. This is the last one on, but the first one off. And so it's important to understand that not all sequencers are made the same. Some are first stage sequencers, some are second stage sequencers. And what I mean by that is I'm going to show you this one right here. It looks the exact same. It looks like a two-stage sequencer. We got the same point of contacts, 1 and 3, 3 or 4 and 5. However, when you look at the printing here, you notice that we've only got one rating. It's going to heat up between 1 and 45 seconds and cool off between 30 and 60 seconds. What that tells us is that these two sets of contacts will open and close at the same time. What you could traditionally use this for is that once 24 volts is applied here and these sets of contacts close, if you had, say, three heaters, you could wire in stage 2 and 3 into this one sequencer and they will come on at the same time. To demonstrate, I'm going to hook up one of these sequencers to our trainer board here. We got our breaker coming in 120 and we're gonna get through the transformer 24 volts and we're gonna time it, see which set of contacts closes first on the stage sequencer. And I'm feeling the heater right now, and it's fairly warm, you know, and as you could see, the top set of contacts was the first to come on and the last to shut off. And that is how a sequencer works. All right, so I just took this off and I'm feeling the heater here and it's fairly warm. I'm not gonna say that the information given out in previous videos was false information, it was simply relative. Some sequencers I have seen where the bottom sets of contacts actually do close before the top sets of contacts. However, as you see, these two sequencers look identical. However, the printed data on them shows that this one is a stage sequencer. This one, the two sets of contacts, they close and open and close at the same time. So you would not want to use this in the same application. The most important takeaway from this video would be read the data on your components before you install them, understand how they work, and pay attention to the heating and cool down rates for each thermodisc. There you go, that's sequencers.